Hello and welcome to Amazing Aircraft, where we explore the history and technology of some of the most incredible flying machines ever created. Today, we are going to take a look at the Sikorsky 3C King, an American twin-engine anti-submarine warfare helicopter that was widely used by various operators around the world for over 50 years. The Sea King was not only a formidable hunter and killer of enemy submarines, but also a versatile and reliable workhorse that could perform many other roles and missions, such as search and rescue, transport, anti-shipping, and airborne early warning. It was also the first helicopter to break several speed records, to retrieve manned space capsules, and to serve as the presidential helicopter. The Sea King was truly a landmark design that revolutionized naval aviation and demonstrated the power and potential of rotary wing aircraft. Let's take a closer look at this amazing aircraft and see what made it so special. The Sea King was born in the 1950s. When the U.S. Navy was facing a growing threat from the Soviet submarine fleet, which was expanding rapidly and becoming more advanced. The Navy needed a new helicopter that could detect and destroy these underwater foes, and that could operate in all weather conditions and from any ship or shore base. Sikorsky, a company that had been making helicopters since the 1930s, was given the task of creating this new machine. But it was not an easy task. Sikorsky had to overcome many challenges and innovations in designing and producing the Sea King. For example, they had to integrate various sensors and systems, such as a dipping sonar, a magnetic anomaly detector, a subway receiver, and a data link to enable the helicopter to locate and track submarines. They also had to make the helicopter amphibious, so that it could land on water and float for long periods of time. They also had to make the helicopter compact enough to fit on the limited space of a ship's deck, so they devised a folding mechanism for the main rudder blades and tail section, which could be activated automatically or manually. And they also had to make the helicopter powerful enough to carry a heavy load of weapons and equipment, so they used the turboshaft engines, which were more efficient and reliable than piston engines. The result of all these efforts was the Sea King, which first flew in 1959 and entered service in 1961. It was one of the first ASW rotorcraft to use turboshaft engines, and it was also one of the first helicopters to be procured under the U.S. Navy's new weapon system concept, which meant that Sikorsky was responsible not only for the airframe, but also for all the onboard systems and support equipment. The Sea King was a breakthrough in helicopter design and technology, and it set a new standard for naval aviation. The Sea King proved to be a valuable asset for the U.S. Navy, as it performed a variety of roles and missions in different theaters and scenarios. The Sea King was not only a formidable hunter and killer of enemy submarines, but also a versatile and reliable workhorse that could perform many other tasks, such as search and rescue, transport, anti-shipping, and airborne early warning. The Sea King also achieved some remarkable feats and records, such as breaking several helicopter speed records, retrieving manned space capsules, rescuing downed aircrew in Vietnam, serving as the presidential helicopter, and conducting anti-ship operations. Let's take a look at some of these achievements and missions in more detail. Speed records. In 1961 and 1962, a modified Sea King was used to break several helicopter speed records. It reached speeds of over 200 mph in various distances and categories, setting an absolute helicopter speed record of 210.6 mph in February 1962. This record was only broken by a French helicopter in July 1963. The Sea King was one of the fastest helicopters of its time, thanks to its powerful turboshaft engines and streamlined design. Space capsules. The Sea King was also the primary helicopter for retrieving manned space capsules from the Mercury, Gemini, and Apollo programs. It was able to locate and hoist the capsules from the ocean, and also to rescue the astronauts inside. The Sea King was involved in many historic space missions, such as Mercury, Atlas 7 in May 1962, which was the third American orbital flight, Apollo 8 in December 1968, which was the first manned mission to orbit the Moon, Apollo 11 in July 1969, which was the first manned mission to land on the Moon, and Apollo 17 in December 1972, which was the last manned mission to land on the Moon. The Sea King played a vital role in supporting the American space program and ensuring the safety of the astronauts. Vietnam. The Sea King was also extensively used during the Vietnam War, where it performed various roles and missions. One of its main roles was to rescue the crews of downed aircraft at sea and overland. The Sea King was equipped with self-sealing fuel tanks, multiple machine guns, and heavy armor to protect itself from enemy fire. It was also able to fly long distances and operate at night, which made it ideal for rescue operations. The Sea King saved hundreds of lives during the war, often under hostile conditions and fire. Presidential helicopter. The Sea King was also used as the official helicopter of the President of the United States, with the call sign Marine One or Army One depending on which service operated it. The Sea King was specially modified for VIP transport, with features such as bulletproof glass, secure communications, air conditioning, and a comfortable interior. The Sea King served as the presidential helicopter from 1961 to 1976, transporting presidents such as John F. Kennedy, Lyndon B. Johnson, Richard Nixon, Gerald Ford, and Jimmy Carter. The Sea King was also involved in some historic events, such as Nixon's visit to China in 1972, which opened diplomatic relations between the two countries, and Nixon's resignation in 1974, which ended his presidency amid the Watergate scandal, anti-ship operations. The Sea King was also capable of conducting anti-ship operations by carrying missiles, such as the Sea Eagle or the Exocet. These missiles could be launched from a distance and guided by radar or infrared to strike enemy ships. The Sea King could also carry torpedoes or depth charges to attack submarines or surface vessels. The Sea King was used for anti-ship operations by several operators around the world, such as Argentina during the Falklands War in 1982, Brazil during its naval patrols in South America, Italy during its participation in NATO exercises, and India during its conflicts with Pakistan. The Sea King was a remarkable aircraft that served with distinction and honor for over 50 years. It performed many roles and missions that showcased its versatility and reliability. It also achieved many feats and records that demonstrated its power and potential. It was truly an amazing aircraft that revolutionized naval aviation and rotary wing technology. The Sea King was such a successful and versatile design that it spawned many variants and derivatives over the years to meet different requirements and needs. Some of these variants were produced by Sikorsky, while others were produced by licensees or customers. Some of these variants were minor modifications, while others were major redesigns. Let's take a look at some of the major variants of the Sea King and see how they differed from the original model. S-61L and S-61N. These were several versions of the Sea King, intended for passenger and cargo transport, especially in remote or offshore areas. The S-61L had a standard fuselage, while the S-61N had a longer fuselage with a rear loading ramp. Both versions had a retractable landing gear and a modified tail rotor. They could seat up to 30 passengers or carry up to 5 tons of cargo. They were used by various operators around the world, such as airlines, oil companies, mining companies, and governments. S-61R. This was a military transport and search and rescue version of the Sea King, with a completely redesigned fuselage and tail section. It had a rear loading ramp, a retractable landing gear, and a larger cabin. It could carry up to 35 troops or 15 stretchers. It was also equipped with a rescue hoist and a refueling probe. It was used by the U.S. Air Force as the CH-3C Sea King and the HH-3E Jolly Green Giant, and by the U.S. Coast Guard and the Italian Air Force as the HH-3F Sea King. S-3D and S-3H, these were improved anti-submarine warfare versions of the Sea King, with more powerful engines and upgraded sensors and systems. The S-3D had two T-50 AGE-10 engines with 1,400 shp each, while the S-3H had two T-50 AGE-100 engines with 1,500 shp each. They also had improved sonar, sonobuoy, radar, and data link equipment. They could carry up to 4 torpedoes or 4 depth charges. They were used by the U.S. Navy and several other navies around the world. HH-3F, this was a coastal patrol version of the Sea King, based on the S-61 upboard with some modifications. It had two T-50 AGE-5 engines with 1,500 shp each, and a smaller cabin with 6 seats. It also had a search radar, a rescue hoist, and a loudspeaker system. It could carry up to 2 torpedoes or 2 depth charges. It was used by the U.S. Coast Guard for search and rescue, law enforcement, environmental protection, and as patrol missions. These were some of the major variants of the Sea King that were produced over the years. There were also many other minor variants that had different configurations or equipment for specific purposes or customers. The Sea King was a highly adaptable and customizable aircraft that could be modified and improved to suit different needs and demands. The Sea King was not only popular in the US, but also in many other countries around the world, both military and civil. The Sea King was exported to various nations, either directly from Sikorsky or through license agreements with other firms. Some of these licensees were Costa in Italy, Mitsubishi in Japan, and Westland in the UK. These firms produced their own versions of the Sea King, sometimes with significant modifications and improvements. Let's take a look at some of the countries that operated or still operate the Sea King and see how they used it for different purposes and missions. Canada. Canada was one of the first foreign customers of the Sea King, acquiring 41 SH-120 for Sea Kings from Sikorsky in 1963. The Canadian Sea Kings were used for anti-submarine warfare, search and rescue, transport, and disaster relief missions. They were also equipped with a winch hold-on landing and securing method, called a bird trap, which allowed them to land on small flight decks or in poor weather conditions. The Canadian Sea Kings served for over 50 years, until they were retired in 2018 and replaced by the SH-140 Sikorsky. Brazil. Brazil was another early customer of the Sea King, acquiring 1-3 Sea Kings from Sikorsky in 1965. The Brazilian Sea Kings were used for anti-submarine warfare, anti-ship, transport, and presidential transport missions. They were also modified by Augusta to carry the Sea Eagle or Exocet missiles for anti-ship operations. The Brazilian Sea Kings served until 1999, when they were replaced by the 60 Seahawk. Italy. Italy was one of the licensees of the Sea King, producing it under the name Augusta S3D. The Italian Sea Kings were used for anti-submarine warfare, search and rescue, transport, and VIP transport missions. They were also equipped with a refueling probe and a rescue hoist. The Italian Air Force operated two S3D variants as VIP transport helicopters from 1975 to 2012. The Italian Navy still operates some S3D variants for anti-submarine warfare and transport missions. Japan. Japan was another licensee of the Sea King, producing it under the name Mitsubishi HSS-2. The Japanese Sea Kings were used for anti-submarine warfare, search and rescue, transport, and airborne early warning missions. They were also equipped with a dipping sonar, a sonobuoy receiver, a magnetic anomaly detector, and a data link. The Japanese Maritime Self-Defense Force operated several variants of the Sea King, such as the HSS-2A, HSS-2B, SHH. Some of them are still in service today. UK. The UK was the largest licensee of the Sea King, producing it under the name Westland Sea King. The British Sea Kings were extensively modified and improved by Westland to suit their needs and demands. They were used for anti-submarine warfare, search and rescue, transport, anti-shipping, airborne early warning, amphibious assault, and special operations missions. They were also equipped with various sensors and systems, such as a radar warning receiver, a chaff dispenser, a flare launcher, an infrared jammer, a sonar processor, a tautery sonar, a radar jammer, and a data link. The British Sea Kings served with various branches of the British Armed Forces, such as the Royal Navy, the Royal Air Force, the Royal Marines, and the Army Air Corps. They also served with several other countries that bought them from Westland or from the UK government as surplus aircraft. Some of these countries include India, Germany, Australia, Norway, Argentina, etc. Some of them are still in service today. These were some of the countries that operated or still operate the Sea King around the world. There were also many other countries that bought or leased the Sea King from Sikorsky or from other operators for various purposes and missions. The Sea King was a highly successful and widely exported aircraft that proved its worth and versatility in different environments and scenarios. We have reached the end of our journey with the Sikorsky's 3 Sea King, an amazing aircraft that made history and changed the world of naval aviation. The Sea King was a breakthrough in helicopter design and technology, as it was one of the first ASW rotorcraft to use turboshaft engines, and it was also one of the first helicopters to be procured under the US Navy's new weapon system concept. The Sea King performed many roles and missions in different theaters and scenarios, such as anti-submarine warfare, search and rescue, transport, anti-shipping, and airborne early warning. The Sea King also achieved many feats and records, such as breaking several helicopter speed records, retrieving manned space capsules, rescuing downed aircrew in Vietnam, serving as the presidential helicopter, and conducting anti-ship operations. The Sea King was also exported to many countries around the world, both military and civil. Some of these countries produced their own versions of the Sea King, sometimes with significant modifications and improvements. The Sea King was a highly adaptable and customizable aircraft that could be modified and improved to suit different needs and demands. The Sea King was a remarkable aircraft that served with distinction and honor for over 50 years. It revolutionized ASW warfare and demonstrated remarkable versatility and reliability in various roles and missions. It was truly an amazing aircraft that left a lasting legacy and impact on the world of rotary wing aircraft. Although many Sea Kings have been retired or replaced by newer helicopters, some examples still remain in service or are preserved in museums. Some of them are still flying for civil operators or foreign customers, while others are on display for the public to admire and appreciate. If you ever have a chance to see or ride a Sea King, don't miss it. You will be amazed by its power and performance, and you will also be reminded of its history and achievements. The Sea King is an aircraft that deserves our respect and admiration, as it is one of the most incredible flying machines ever created. Thank you for watching this episode of Amazing Aircraft. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. And if you have any comments or questions about the Sea King or any other aircraft, please leave them below. We would love to hear from you. Until next time, stay safe and keep flying.